Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to another 5 Minute Friday. It's great to have you here. If you're new, consider hitting the subscribe button if you learn something from this. I'm Jessica McGovern, multi-award winning international portrait photographer. And today I'm going to hopefully share some little secrets about a specific tool in Photoshop to enrich your life. I have 5 minutes, so without further ado, let's get stuck in. We're going to be in Photoshop. It doesn't really matter which version you're in, but the newest one is always useful. The tool that we're going to discuss today and hopefully share some additional things about it is, as you will already know from the title of this, the healing brush tool, not the spot healing brush tool or the clone source tool, the patch tool, or any of the other healing tools. We're talking specifically about the healing brush tool. The healing brush tool is a misunderstood tool, and I'm here to show you that it's actually the best one of all of the above that I've mentioned to use in your retouching, and hopefully share a few little tips and tricks along the way. So what is the healing brush tool? Where do you find it? Well, in Photoshop, no matter which workspace you're in, you should be able to find the little icon on the side, which is often just set up as the spot healing brush tool. It looks like a plaster with a little circle. You want to right click on that and select the healing brush tool from the list. Now, what is the healing brush tool? Technically, it's kind of an amalgamation between the healing powers of the spot healing brush tool and the clone source tool. So it also takes a sample of a pattern, but then it blends it really nicely. First things first, if you're brand new, you want to go find something you want to remove. In this case, it's a lens mark. I'm going to go ahead and change the brush size. We've done keyboard shortcuts before. We're going to take a sample by holding down the Option key, Alt on a Windows. Take a sample from an area that you're wanting to duplicate, go ahead and go over the bit you're wanting to fix, and then just blend in a little circle. Easiest way of doing it. But really, that's very basic. Now on Dora here, we can see that she's got this area of coat naturally sat in that way, but this is quite unsightly. It's a bit distracting for me. If I want to heal this area, we've got different options. We could use the clone stamp tool. We could use a content aware fill. But if I pull from another area and replace that here using the healing brush tool, what you can see is that the coat's going, because it pulls the texture and blends the colors, coat's going in a very specific direction, and that's downwards, whereas this part of the neck obviously needs to be going outwards. So what can we do? Easy peasy lemon squeezy. We want to go ahead and grab our healing brush tool here, take a sample from the opposite side if you've got a symmetrical situation, go to your clone source panel if you don't have that window clone source, and go to your little W section and hit the little flippy icon. That's going to flip it horizontal. So what we can now do is line up where that location was, and if you're struggling, pick a landmark like the edge of the coat, line that up on the other side, and then we want to go ahead and blend. And what we're going to do is we're going to take an exact opposite of the area that we're working on and replace it to the other side. And so what we're left with is actually a pretty damn good heal. We've got the before and the after. You can also do all your normal things that you can do with a clone source, including your rotations, which you can use a keyboard shortcut for, but it's a lot quicker to go ahead and use that. So by utilizing our clone source panel and the healing brush tool, what we can end up doing is blending and cloning at the exact same time. So you don't have it in unsightly clone marks and the colors are blended nicely. But there are limitations to the healing brush tool. And I've got this image open as an example because the limitations of the healing brush tool tend to happen when you hit a highly contrasted area or an area that already has an object. So for example, what we could not do in this image is go ahead and run a source. Let's just take this as an example and reset my source off. And if we went over the line of the subject, it tries to blend and in the process makes a right old mess. So you don't want to go over any solid lines. For lighter areas, it will get confused at first. And this is a very important point. So what we want to do is take a sample source, an area of texture maybe, and then if we start going over a light area, it kind of gets a bit confused and it turns into a mush. Keep your mouse pressed down and keep working the area. And what it will do is it will, can you see it's starting to darken everything that we've just done? So it's working through those areas and then going back and going, okay, you want me to be darker. You want me to be darker, I will go darker. And so in the process, if you just keep your mouse pressed down or your stylus pressed down, if you're using a Wacom, and keep working it in little circles, you will end up with a really clean transition between the two. When we've cleaned up all of these different areas really nicely, we end up with an image that's transformed simply by removing those bokeh spots. So using that healing brush tool really blends it through in a much quicker, more efficient and seamless way than it would do if we use the clone source or the spot healing brush tool. Spot healing brush tool liable to leave little lines, whereas the clone source tool gives you an exact duplication. And so usually you'll need to do additional work to blend the lightness, the color, the saturation, the tone, the hue, everything else that you need to do, including the pattern and also the depth. So by using the healing brush tool, you cut down on all of the additional time, all of the retouching touch-ups that you have to do because you've done your retouching, and in the end, you end up with an image that looks absolutely epic and is ready to be finished off. And that is why the healing brush tool is literally the best thing since sliced bread, because it both clones and it heals and blends all at the same time and gives you all the flexibility of your clone source transform tools. That's today's 5-Minute Friday. Hopefully that was useful for you. If it was, please do let me know. If you want me to do a 5-Minute Friday on something else, put it in the comments. Let's have a chat about that. Hopefully you're enjoying these and I can't wait to see you soon. See you next week for a challenge review video.